Hi, I'm Susan Beggins, and I am an encourager, a scribe, and the silly mother of hobbits, and a dog and a bird, which hopefully you will not hear during this recording. You never know. And I wanted to come to you with a diddly squat today about courage. Let's think of the cowardly lion. I want courage. And I encountered this need for courage. I actually realized that fear was such a huge part of my life when I was writing. I think it's always been a part of my life, and I still have some fears that I have to deal with. But when I was writing, it was when I finally really understood how much it really controlled me, in that I would get to a point in my story and some would call it writer's block. I would think that this is crap, this is the worst thing anybody's ever written, nobody's ever going to want to read this, I've just wasted all this time, it's the stupidest thing on earth. And then I come back after prayer and I write, and I cannot tell you in any of my novels, and I've got many of them out there, that where that spot is in the story. So I call it a wall of fear, not a writer's block, because that's really what it is. It's just fear. But I've encountered fear in other places in my life too. So I began to understand many years ago now that I was in a relationship with somebody who was verbally abusive. That includes emotional abuse, that includes gaslighting, that includes neglect, it includes financial abuse. It was not a healthy relationship, and everything I had tried to do over the years would not change that. I prayed, I read books, I got counseling, I tried to encourage, you know, marriage therapy. We went to a marriage retreat once. That didn't do any good. And it just couldn't break through. And I started to understand how devastating this stuff was, but I was always afraid to leave. Now, somebody accused me then of just, you know, not doing what I needed to do, but I did have to trust and follow God in this as well. It wasn't like I could just leave. And anybody who is in a verbally, emotionally, whatever relationship, don't just leave. Get counsel, get help, get support, have a safety plan. Sometimes it can be more dangerous to leave that than it is to stay, if you don't do it right, because somebody who is verbally abusive can become physically abusive, especially when it comes to ending the relationship. That can happen. So it got to a point where God pushed me into a corner, and I knew he was probably going to have to do this, because I really was afraid of trying to navigate life as a single mom. Now, I call myself a single mom. Yes, I am legally divorced. And I have three children. I have full custody, full placement. There's joint custody, full placement of my kids. They are with me 98% of the time. And I'm grateful for that. But going into this, I knew that it was going to be something that God was going to have to push me into. And once he did, I was committed. And I just fully trusted in him. And that was where the courage came into. The courage that I could trust God to be my provider, to see me through this. And it was amazing. I mean, I could go on and on about all the ways that God met me as I went through this process of becoming legally single. How's that sound? And I still, to this day, even though I'm legally single, face a lot of fears. And I have to have the courage to say, okay, God, I'm trusting you. I'm trusting the leading of your Holy Spirit as I navigate this day, this week, this month, as I try to figure out my finances, as I did my taxes, as I take care of the needs of my children that come up, getting them to doctor appointments and dealing with academic issues and, you know, all those things that happen when you have kids. And so, anyway, I just wanted to come and share with you about that, because I think fear, it's not something that God wants us to live in. And so it's hard, even when you're in a difficult situation like I was with my marriage, to say, okay, I'm afraid to leave, but to have the courage to stay, because that's really what it was, the courage to stay and trust God to provide a way out for me. Because I figured he could get me out of this. My husband could change. Somebody could die. who knows what could happen. Or he could choose to divorce me, which he didn't. I was the one who left. But like I said, God forced that issue for me where I felt I had no other recourse than to make that decision, that choice, for the sake of my children. First, my children were my first priority. The secondary blessing was for me, in that after 27 years of praying and seeking God, he provided a way out. And he did that in a way that was safe for me and for my kids, and he is continuing to be my provider in spite of my fears. So courage is something that I don't know a lot about, and I'm still discovering as I trust God and the Holy Spirit to lead and guide and provide for me in the midst of this, as I seek him, as I seek to follow where he leads, which might not be conventional wisdom. And that's where real courage comes in, is to say, okay, I am going to do what God calls me to do. And first and foremost, my responsibility is to my children. And then secondly, I need to be able to take care of myself. So beyond that, everything is got to be what God is leading me to do. So the work that I'm trying to do, and the writing and the editing and the speaking engagements, those are all things that I have to seek God for. And trust in his provision, because it's not like I can write, you know, several chapters in a week and get a paycheck for it. There's a payoff somewhere down the line for those works, that effort and that time that I put in, but it's not immediate. And so somebody said to me, well, it's like passive income. And in a way, it is passive income, in that once I've done all the work, the income comes in. And I can do marketing and stuff, but ultimately God's the one who's in charge of how much money I make. So, trusting God, having courage to follow where he leads, is something that I'm still struggling with and learning about and trying to grow in as I navigate this new life as a single mom. And I try to learn ways to be healthy and safe and vibrant. That's a way to thrive in my new life. That's not an easy thing, because for the longest time I couldn't thrive very well. And now I have that freedom to do that. And so it's making choices to step out and try to thrive. So that is my diddly squat for today. And if you are struggling with fear, I pray that you would find that God is your anchor in the midst of your storm, that he is the one who will provide, and that you can lean and trust in him. He is faithful, always. And it always strikes me that in the Old Testament, Joshua often says, be bold and strong as you trust in the Lord. And there's my dog, who is very small, being bold and strong, barking at somebody walking outside the house. So, be like my dog, and face your fears without any hesitation, because that's what courage is. Blessings to you. May God richly bless you as you seek him. Thank you.